Well, welcome. Welcome to the kindergarten graduation. Want to just say that this is an exciting day. It's really great to just see everybody sitting out here. They're sitting in families, and it's just like, you know, 18 of my favorite families that are all just here for this special event. You know, and it's not just a special event because I'm looking at 8 more years of tuition stability. It is a special event because this really marks the beginning of education as they grow each year. And we've seen them grow this year. Oh my, it has been amazing. It's been awesome. What a great, great kindergarten class. But I just want to say welcome. We are glad you're here. We are glad that you have entrusted your most valuable possessions, your children, to the partnership of Adventist Education.
I would also like to add my welcome to the families that are here, and I know that some have come from a long ways away, so thank you for coming and sharing this special event with us. There are also families that haven't been able to be here for this event, and they are live streaming our program, so hopefully they will be watching as well. We welcome them. At this time, I'm going to have everyone please stand, and my friend Denera, if you'll come to me, sweet girl, is going to open up our ceremony with a prayer.
Close your eyes and bless your heads. Thank you for this day. Have blessedly to keep kindergarten going. Thank you for graduation and everything else. And thank you for the universe. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Denera. At this time, we're also going to sing for you a song that we have been learning for the past few weeks. Well, all through the year, whenever we do our flag salute, I'd like for them to learn a new patriotic song. And so the one that we have chosen for this occasion is America the Beautiful, in honor of our wonderful country.
Thank you.
Whenever we attend an event like this, what we see is the culmination of many hours of time and energy expended by many individuals to get us to where we are now. And there are several individuals that I would like to acknowledge and thank at this time. I would like to thank my colleagues for their support to make this a memorable and fun event. First of all, Miss Mimi, the face of KAES, the first one you see, has shared some balloons with us, and they are attached to the gift bags that the children will receive. Also for Mr. Coulter, who's here to present the diplomas, and also for the Keene Church staff for supporting our kindergarten class and allowing us to meet here this evening. I want to give a big thank you to George Velez and his crew of helpers for helping things to go smoothly with the sound system and the technology. So thank you all very, very much. And I'm going to go back just a few months and highlight the special events and holiday celebrations that were fun because of the generosity and time and yummy treats that the parents provided. The children felt very, very loved and enjoyed every minute. So thank you, parents, for sharing your time and your energy to celebrate with us. The biggest event in a 5 or 6 year old's life is celebrating their long-awaited birthday. This year we enjoyed cookies, cupcakes, donuts, and fruit cups, all yummy treats. And in September, we welcomed grandparents to our school and to our classroom. They came, many of you who are here, you came to our classroom, you played table games with the children. In November, we shared a delicious meal at our Thanksgiving celebration, and the children learned how to count their blessings and make a thankful tree out of a brown paper bag. Next, we had a wonderful Christmas party complete with a book exchange game and piñata fun. And old and young got to hit the very sturdy piñata. In January, we celebrated the 100th day of school and being 100 days smarter. Valentine's Day was special because of all the delicious goodies and the cards that were shared. Our field trips to Mainstay Farm in the fall and the Fort Worth Zoo in the spring were fun because of the parents who went along to chaperone and enjoy the day with our class. And today will certainly be memorable because of the dedicated parents who provided time and talent to make this graduation celebration special. I would like to give a heartfelt thanks to Jennifer Smith and Jacqueline Munoz, who kind of took the lead and they organized the decorations and all the nice things that we'll see in our reception hall. And there were lots of others. Oh, Miss Escobar, Iris, who designed the little t-shirts that the kids are gonna get. And it goes with our theme of the Dr. Seuss theme. But everyone who has had a part in helping to decorate this evening and for bringing refreshments for the reception, very much thanks. And thank you to everyone who shared time and energy with us again. Now, there is no way that I can, in just a few sentences, describe the curriculum that I use in my classroom. I use the lessons from the North American Division kindergarten curriculum called Stepping Stones. And what I appreciate the most is the fact that all the monthly units and lessons have an important underlying objective. And that is to make the invisible God visible. Sometimes we as adults even have a hard time with that one. But through these lessons, the children have learned who the Creator is, who their Savior is, and who their best friend is. And what a privilege it has been for me to be able to weave the spiritual lessons into our subjects and activities each day. These children love to talk about spiritual topics, which you probably already know. But they embody the Bible verse that talks about having the faith of a little child. And you as their family have laid the foundation for your child's interest of spiritual themes by reading and sharing with them Bible stories, taking them to Sabbath school, teaching them about God's nature. And it's my prayer that we will continue to work together as a church and school to fill them with the love and knowledge of Jesus as their personal friend and Savior. I pray that their lives will be so blessed that they in turn will be a blessing to their home and community on this earth, and especially the heavenly kingdom to come. This year, each child has grown physically in proportion to their maturity. If losing a collective total of 20 teeth is any indication of their growth, then you know they've done a lot of growing. They have also, as a class, grown 29 and a half inches. That's an average of 1.6 inches each. And collectively, they have gained about 61 and a half pounds. That's an average of 3.4 pounds per student for these past 10 months. It has been my privilege to witness their growth and maturity, and I look forward to seeing each child continue to grow and mature and accomplish wonderful things in their lives. At this time, I would like to invite, well, we're going to have some special music, and I'm going to invite, first of all, Noah to come up, and Noah is going to play Amazing Grace. With his teacher, Ms. Lizeth Pasillas. Thank you, Noah. Next, I would like to invite Stella Yang to come up, and she is going to play Ode to Joy with her mother, her teacher, Miss Iris Yang.
Thank you.
Thank you, Stella. And next, we're going to have Weslyn Patterson. Could Weslyn please come up? And she will play When the Saints Go Marching. There is no way you could have gotten me up front at 5 or 6 years old, but they did a great job. Thank you, boys and girls. Now, just a few words about the diplomas that they will be receiving this evening. It's just a decoy, and you'll see why during the program. But later on, the children will be receiving their gift bag with the fancy, colorful diploma. And the bags are going to be over by their presentation boards, and you can pick them up as you leave this evening. They are individually labeled with their names, and please wait to open them when you get home, until you get home. Okay, ready for the diplomas. I have had a wonderful year because of the precious children that have been shared with me. Their uniqueness and individuality is what makes teaching interesting year after year. Their innocence and willingness to learn and please their teacher is what has endeared them to me. As the diplomas are handed out by Mr. Coulter this evening, I will focus on a gift that is part of the student's personality. Each child is unique and has many talents, but I have chosen a specific gift to highlight today. Boys and girls, when you hear your name, come up and receive your diploma from Mr. Coulter. Mr. Coulter, we practiced, so they're going to shake your hand and hold the pose for the mom and dad to take their picture. Mm-hmm. Okay, and the list of students that's in the bulletin is the order that they will get their diploma. So if you want to get ready for your picture. Okay, we will start with John Paul Fernandez. John Paul has a gift of storytelling. He has a good memory for, this way, John Paul. He has a good memory for details and important facts. John Paul's favorite memory of kindergarten is doing the morning name cards to welcome him to class each day. When he grows up, John Paul wants to work at Southwestern and teach others about feelings like his mom. Okay, next, Evie Cias. Evie has the gift of artistic ability, and along with that comes neat handwriting also. One of her favorite memories of kindergarten is doing the pledge and patriotic song at calendar time. Evie wants to be a teacher when she grows up and teach kids to pray nicely. Jacob Addison. Jacob has a gift of knowing about many creatures in nature. One of his favorite memories of kindergarten is playing with his friends at recess on the playground. When he grows up, Jacob wants to be an animal scientist to help animals to not be extinct. Next, Diadem Neighbors. Diadem has a gift of being kind and polite to everyone. Diadem's favorite memory of kindergarten is the field trip to Mainstay Farm last fall. Diadem would like to be a chef when she grows up so she can make an apple pie. Next, Benjamin Kiech. Benjamin has the gift of being dependable. If I needed something taken to the office or someone escorted to Miss Mimi for an ice pack, I could count on him to get the job done. Benjamin's favorite memory of kindergarten is learning about math and what the minus sign means. When Benjamin grows up, he would like to be a policeman and tell people how fast they are going. Next, Pepper Baumgartner. Pepper has a gift of being a great listener and following directions and not distracting others. One of Pepper's favorite memories of kindergarten is putting on the links at calendar time. Pepper would like to be a teacher when she grows up so she can teach kids to do number bonds. That's a math thing. Hudson Smith. Hudson has the gift of courtesy. He is always polite and thoughtful to his teachers and classmates. His favorite memory of kindergarten is of being the leader and doing calendar time. Hudson wants to be a game warden and Coast Guard when he grows up so he can help people. Weslyn Patterson. Weslyn has the gift of knowing and understanding numbers. She makes connections with numbers that are amazing. Her favorite memory of kindergarten was doing math and learning more about numbers. When she grows up, Weslyn would like to make food at Chick-fil-A. Caleb Bells. Caleb has the gift of strength and coordination. He is a sought-after athlete for games. Caleb's best memory of kindergarten was being the leader and putting on the links to count how many days of school. When Caleb grows up, he wants to go to the military to help protect people. Sarah Fernandez. Sarah has the gift of being a peacemaker. She gets along with others and does her best in all her work. Sarah's favorite memory of kindergarten was going to the zoo this spring. Sarah would like to be a chef when she grows up so she can make rice and beans. Yum. Next, Dristan Duncan. Dristan has the gift of a sweet singing voice. We sing songs about everything, and I can count on Tristan to help carry the tune for our a cappella songs. His favorite memory of kindergarten is playing in the kitchen center at Center's Time. Tristan would like to grow up and be a karate teacher and do practice fighting to protect himself. Next, Noah Munoz. Noah has the gift of reading. He follows along as I read storybooks, and he corrects me if I deviate from the written words. One of Noah's favorite memories is counting by fives at calendar time. Noah would like to be a zookeeper when he grows up and help take care of snakes. Denara Thomas. Denara has the gift of being a deep thinker. I can count on her to listen carefully and give thoughtful answers during discussions. One of her favorite memories is putting the links on the board at calendar time. When she grows up, Denara wants to be a gymnastics teacher and teach students to do cartwheels. Next, Sammy Escobar. Sammy has the gift of being good at math. He learned to write and use numbers. Sammy's favorite memory of kindergarten is that his teacher is nice. Thank you, Sammy. Sammy would like to be a scientist and a soccer player when he grows up. Next, Naomi Gutwa. Naomi has a gift of making friends. Her smiles and giggles attract friends. One of Naomi's favorite memories is of being the leader and counting the links on the board. When Naomi grows up, she would like to be a policewoman so she can catch the bad guys. Isaiah Roldan. Isaiah has the gift of learning. He catches on quickly and retains what he has learned. One of his favorite memories of kindergarten is about playing in the kitchen center. Isaiah would like to be a chef when he grows up and have a pizza restaurant. Okay, next, Stella Yang. Stella has a gift of languages. When she started kindergarten, her English was limited. After being in pre-K and now in kindergarten, she is able to communicate in English as well as her native Korean. She is truly becoming bilingual. Stella's favorite memory is playing on the playground swings with her friends. When she grows up, Stella would like to be a nurse to help sick children. Okay, next, Levi Coleman. Levi has a gift of affection. You know what I'm talking about because many of you here have been recipients of his hugs and affection. One of his favorite memories is being the leader and adding the links on the calendar. When Levi grows up, he would like to be a chef to make chicken nuggets and French fries. Moms and dads, family and friends, Mr. Samaniego, it is my pleasure to present to you the 2023 kindergarten graduates and future first graders. The kindergarten class would now like to recite a Bible passage that gives us peace in these troubled times and also hope for the future. These words were spoken by Jesus to his disciples on the night before he was taken to Calvary. These words were intended to bring comfort to them during the dark times that were ahead. We hope that it will bring peace and joy to you as well. Boys and girls, look this way, please. Danera, turn this way. Let our class also has a song that we would like to sing for you tonight. It is a declaration of our love for Jesus, as well as an invitation to join us in preparing to live with Jesus forever. The song is called, I Have Decided to Follow Jesus. At this time, Caleb Bells is going to have our closing prayer.
Well, if you haven't been blessed, I know we have, and I'm not going to cry, but we wanted to make sure that we give Mrs. Just a really huge thank you, because I know all of the parents... Mrs. Just, all of the parents, I know I speak on our behalf when we say that we are not only blessed to have our children in your classroom learning education and their ABCs and their 1, 2, 3s, but learning their path to heaven. You're all crying out there too. So anyways, hey class, can you guys tell Mrs. Jess thank you? You ready? On one, two, three.
Thank you.
We hope you enjoy a lot of relaxation that's in that gift card, as you may disappear for a little bit of your summer first. And thank you for all the patience and the godliness that you've exhibited to each of these kids. Oh, and this is for Missouri.
Well, I can't do what I do on my own. God is my helper, as I hope he is your helper as well. It's hard to live and work in this world where anything can happen at any moment, and you're responsible for children like this. I take it very seriously. I enjoy what I do, and I can't do it without parent support as well. So thank you very much for your prayers and your help this year. Okay, at this time, could we all stand for closing prayer? And Caleb is going to have the prayer for us.
Davidy Father, thank you for this day. Thank you that you helped us to do good. In Jesus' name we pray, amen.
Thank you, Caleb. At this time, you may have a seat. The children are going to walk out while Mrs. Yang plays, so thank you very much for coming. Oh, there is a reception that I would like to invite everyone to come and enjoy with us and take lots and lots of pictures. Okay, boys and girls, watch. Go back to your place. Watch Levi. He's going to be our leader.